libraries are the heart and soul of a university, and that's as true today as it was when I was a student back here in the 70s and I first found the library in the sky in Centennial Hall. Libraries connect our researchers to cutting-edge research. Libraries hold special collections that very much relate to our personal identity as a university.
There's something about university libraries that people remember in ways that I think they maybe don't remember other campus spaces. Maybe where they met their spouse. It might be where they had a eureka moment that led to a career path somewhere.
It's a really important place in the university. It's where a lot of research is done, a lot of studying, where people go to really improve on themselves, their grades, and how well they can actually do in school.
My hub was kind of the Duckworth Center, and it was a really nice shift, like an energy shift, to be able to come into the library versus being in that space all the time.
My mother used to take me here as a child in the 80s. It was an exciting place to be because there was a lot of nooks and crannies. I would come up here with her to get books for the class, and it sparked my curiosity about what she was teaching.
You hear a lot about this affection for the library that we have on campus. It's kind of time we loved it back a little bit. This library was built when there was about a quarter of the student population that we have now. The way that we've had to grow into it is not giving our students and faculty the kind of space that they deserve. This was created as a two-phase process that would allow us to do some visioning and thinking about what a modern library means for U of W.
What we heard in consultation was, better quality space, so better access to natural light, more open collaborative spaces, the exterior facade is leaking, it needs new windows, but also touching on accessibility. 40% of the floor area is inaccessible, so could we link the mezzanines through bridges and bring the mezzanines up to an accessible level?
The digital age has changed research, it's changed learning, so it's about connecting students with technology.
More plugins, better Wi-Fi, better access to digital materials.
Ensuring that two or three or five or eight people can sit together in a room looking at a screen.
What sets this project apart is that stance that, yes, we want this place to reflect indigenization and in a meaningful way.
Indigenization is good for all of us. It's good for all of our students. Canada's success and the success of our Indigenous peoples are tightly linked. We have chosen to make the heart of our university, our library, the cornerstone of indigenization.
We didn't just want a library that had an Indigenous section in it. We wanted to make a statement about the entire university through a redesign of the library.
How can we create a sense of space that speaks to Indigenous ways of gathering? And how can that create an identity for the library?
Ryan has thought through a celestial wayfinding design that would lead people around the library and guide them to different areas, which is quite beautiful.
I also am very excited about having signage in Indigenous languages. We are also committed to developing Indigenous language programs, so that would coincide with that initiative as well.
When we bring other ways of knowing, other ways of research into these spaces, we create a more active environment.
As a learner, you get to walk into the library and think, this is a space that was designed with me in consideration.
A new design presents opportunities to bring communities in the surrounding area together with faculty, students, and staff, and that's what libraries are supposed to do.
We want it to be a space that a child could come into with their mom and say, wow, I want to be a student too.
I love this institution. It's such an important part of the community, and it's growing and drawing people in a way that is critical.
We want this to be a place where our students feel safe, inspired, and supported, and we want Indigenous pedagogy and Indigenous design to be front and center, respected, and privileged.
When you create the types of space we're talking about, people will want to be here.
I just hear such wonderful feedback about the library and how people feel about it getting some love because they feel such love for it.
I'm really excited about it. I can't wait to see where it goes.